Hey, it's Sam with Billet Services. Just wanted to follow up and show you what it's like to work with HDR content in Adobe Premiere, show you some of its quirks, and show you how to color manage and grade your content in HDR in Premiere. Now, I'm starting with a sequence that I've already set up, just like I showed you in the last video. Everything is working in HDR, and I'm outputting HDR to my reference displays. I'm capturing that output with an Atomos Sumo. I'll replace myself here with that content whenever I want to show you what the output looks like. So let's go ahead and turn to Premiere. I've got this sequence set up. We're gonna start by looking at HEVC content when we're doing HDR content here in Premiere. So I've just got some clips from my DJI drone, my Mavic 2 Pro. And if we look here, this looks fine, but we're actually not looking at the Mavic Pro RAWs or the files that came off the camera. If I take this top layer and we're gonna disable it, this is what the DJI content looks like when I bring it into Premiere. Well, that doesn't look right. There's no data in these waveforms. And in fact, if I go to my sequence settings and change it away from HDR, you'll see that this is not a problem with the files. The data is there. It's just however Adobe is interpreting that HEVC content in HDR, we're not seeing it created properly. This top layer is those same files just run through DaVinci Resolve. And we can see here when I turn them on, that we're getting proper log footage, okay? So this is coming in and Adobe's interpreting it as Rec. 709. So it's not seeing it as log, it just thinks it's Rec. 709 content, which is fine. So if I want to color manage this, I'm just gonna select it, go over to Lumetri, browse for a custom LUT. In this case, I'm gonna pick my DJI D-Gamut D-Log to Adobe Premiere HDR LUT. And when I turn that on, we can see that this looks like proper HDR content. We've color managed the drone footage into HDR, and I can start with that for the grade. So with HEVC content, if it looks like it's coming in a little bit funky, converting it to ProRes with Rec. 709 flags will let you work with it in HDR in Adobe Premiere. Similar thing or another strange thing happens when we're working with already graded HDR content. So right here, this is my first vlog. This is the master file in ProRes. We can see it's coming in. It looks it's proper HDR. That's what it's supposed to look like. This layer here is an HEVC, an MP4 HDR10 version of the same content. There's no colorimetry difference between the data in these files. But when I turn it on, this is not what the HDR looks like. I have looked and tried to figure out exactly how Adobe is interpreting these HDR10 files, but no matter what I do, I can't get them to look right. If I do an exposure adjustment down, I'm still getting these hot spots on my head. The red channel is off the chart. I genuinely have no idea why that's not working. So again, if you need to bring in already graded HDR content in PQ, you're not gonna wanna use HDR10, you're gonna wanna bring it in a ProRes master file. Speaking of ProRes master files, if we go here to our PQ content and I try to interpret the PQ footage in the ProRes file, or sorry, this is the MP4, I really have no way of changing it. So even though in the ProRes version, I can override the color space and tell it to interpret as something else, in the HDR10 HEVC version, I can't. I don't know why this is a choice that Adobe's made, but you're gonna run into this over and over again where it's interpreting different codecs, the same data, but in different codecs in wildly different ways and giving you different options. And that's probably the biggest thing that I had to figure out what was happening in order to actually start working in HDR in Premiere and in After Effects. Let's go look at HLG because this starts getting really, really wonky. So this is HLG content that I just shot in my backyard. So I've actually taken the same clip and this was shot on my GH5S, shot it in HLG. So this first one here, the camera native, is an AVC 10-bit, so H.264. And we can see that Adobe's interpreting it as if it's Rec. 709, and all we're getting is a Rec. 709 rendering. The next clip is the same content, just rendered as 10-bit HEVC with the HLG flags. So we can see that as we hop over there, suddenly we're using the full HDR dynamic range of PQ. We're clipping wildly, the contrast is off. I don't really know where it's going from there. So when it comes to color management with HLG, I've actually had to make a couple of separate color management LUTs. So these are going to work separately or differently for AVC and for HEVC. So this first one for AVC, we're going to put it on the AVC clip, and that's going to normalize it into a normal HDR range, something that I can start grading with and work from there. Same thing with the HEVC. If I go to the LUTs, I needed a different LUT to work with the HEVC because Adobe's interpreting it differently. So when I bring that in, again, you can see we've normalized it. They're pretty close. They're not identical. There's a slight exposure difference between the two. That's because I couldn't get it to match flawlessly, but both of these are great starting points for grading or for working with your HLG content. This is the ProRes version of the same file, which, as you can see, has come in again completely differently. It's somewhere in between the AVC and the HEVC content, but this is something that you could start grading with right away. So I haven't made a color management LUT for that. Anyway, so that's with the HLG. And again, these are in DaVinci Resolve. These all line up with exactly the same RGB payload once they're decoded and brought into an RGB space. So I don't know why Adobe's colors are so different, but they are. So you need to work with the codecs that you have. And again, if you need to convert anything to ProRes, that's going to give you a good 10-bit starting point for your grading, for your work, and it'll overcome a lot of the problems that I'm seeing with AVC and especially with HEVC. So how do we actually do color management and grading here in Premiere? Well, I built these Adobe Premiere HDR color management LUTs that are going to take the common camera log and wide color gamut formats and bring them into Adobe's Rec. 709 Gamma 2.4 based HDR. So if we take a look at here, here's the DJI content that I just started with the beginning. We're going to go to an input LUT, select our DJI D-Gamut D-Log to Adobe Premiere, open it up, and that started with a normalization of the footage. You can see over here on my waveform, I'm now peaking above the SDR 100 nits. I can go over to my exposure and start working on what my grade is going to look like. I can add some contrast, can shift it to a much cooler color temperature, make it nighty feel. We can dim it down. Well, that went too far. And dim it down, crush the highlights to make it feel like I shot this at night, and suck out some saturation. Let's do a quick grade like that. So now this looks more like an evening shot, make it even bluer, and now we've got some nighttime. We've done all that with Lumetri, all with the basic corrections, and we're able to get a really quick grade, capture the look that we want with very little headache. Same thing with this DJI shot. We're going to apply the same LUT as our starting point. That's handling our color management. You can see the footage has been normalized. This one here, the sky is a little crushed. I want to bring up the sky. We're going to pull up the highlights. We're going to drop down the exposure a little bit, and we're going to give it a nice boost in saturation to bring out those blues and golden tones. Now, as I scrub through that, you can see just how nice that looks. Now, one of the things that you might notice is that as I start scrubbing and moving my playhead, while I am telling it to work in a high bit depth, my bit depth automatically drops. I start getting this block artifacting that you should be able to see, especially later on in this clip, actually, if I bring it up and just we'll pull that out. You can see it right here in the sky. I'm just getting this banding and block artifacting all through the sky. That's because Adobe is dropping the bit depth as I scrub in order to be able to play it back in any kind of real time. The same thing happens if I hit play, it immediately drops in bit depth. But when I'm paused, I can look at it in its full bit depth and in full HDR. Now, what's concerning is that as I do my Lumetri adjustments, the bit depth drops as well. And so as I'm shifting these around, you can see on the waveform especially, and on the monitors, that I've dropped my bit depth and I'm getting that banding artifacting. That can make it really hard to do subtle adjustments. So that's just another thing to look out for when you're grading with Adobe Premiere. So this here is different footage. We'll move on here. This is some Panasonic V-Log footage. And you can see I've just done a nice little grade on here. So we've pushed up the highlights of the sun. We've brought down the midtones. And here you can see that my default SDR rendering that Adobe's doing in my preview window actually looks pretty good. So this content is fairly dark and most of it's landing in the SDR range. So even if you don't have an HDR external monitor, you still should be able to do at least a basic SDR grade. You just won't be able to see your highlights. Now that's for something like an Atomos Sumo or even a very inexpensive display HDR desktop monitor comes in where you'll be able to see a little bit more of those highlights as long as you output a clean HDR signal using an IO box like the Blackmagic Ultra Studio Mini 4K. So if I show you here, here's another piece of Panasonic footage. I'm going to show you how I grade this one. So this is from that same sunrise shoot. I'm going to go here and I'm going to switch to my Panasonic LUT, V-Log V-Gamut, to Adobe HDR. We're going to apply that. You can see here, I like the image. I like how it's rendered, but I want it to be a little bit warmer so we can warm it up. And you can see really clearly that banding in the highlights as I adjust that slider. It's getting really blocky around the sun, really blocky. But we're going to warm it to about there, let go. That looks about right. We're going to adjust our exposure up just a little bit and boost the contrast to really sink those darks. I want the low parts of the image to look a little bit darker. So we're just going to grab our shadows and slide them down. And again, you can see that the SDR rendering of this is actually a really great starting point for a good generic HDR look. Now, if I was using a Sony BVMX or an FSI XM310K, like I'd have that top end brightness that I might want to push this brighter. But overall, for a sunrise feel, I'm really happy with how that looks, right? I can still push my sun up a little bit higher with a highlight adjustment, or I'll go into the curves here. We're gonna grab our RGB curves and we're just gonna give a little bit of a boost to the high ends to really push up the brightness of the sun up to that 1000 nits range, which is kind of the max that we'll wanna use for an HDR content. And then we can see that that's a really, really bright, it's really powerful. It looks more like we're looking into the sun. And I really like that look. So the last thing that I wanted to show you here with the grading is the difference between raw content and proxy content. Or in this case, I'm dealing with RAWs and a high-grade ProRes. So this here is from a shoot that I shot in spring 2020 that I had the Red RAWs for, and I wanted to show you the difference. This first clip is the R3D. If we zoom in here, you can see we've got the Red RAW R3D, and next to it, I've got the proxy MOV that was generated using the camera settings, using and pushing it into Red Wide Gamut Log 3G10. So this was great for editing, and it was a great starting point for grading, but I want to show you what this looks like when we come to interpreting it. Right now in my basic corrections, I've thrown on my Red Wide Gamut to Log 3G10. This is how it came in, okay, which is a nice log footage, exactly what we would expect. It was ProRes, so there was no funky interpretations by Adobe. And I've added my LUT, and we have a really great base starting point. The colors are looking good. The overall contrast looks right. I've captured all of the detail and the highlights, and I can go and grade that. Now, when I jump over to my R3D, you can see I have nothing on in Lumetri, right? But I'm getting this kind of wonky image. That's part of the problem with the default mastering settings when you bring it in the R3D. If we go down here to the bottom, you'll see that it's outputting a Rec. 709 BT1886, which is a gamma 2.4 transfer function. This is not what we want for HDR. So we're going to switch these to a Red Wide Gamut Log 3G10. And when we look at that waveform, that looks a lot like the default waveform that we saw with that other content. So we'll go back out of there, back over to the grade. And now we can see we have something that we can start grading with. Now, this has more contrast than the ProRes file. If I turn off the LUT, you can see that it's got a little bit more contrast, a little bit more brightness, And it's coming in more or less in HDR. In fact, if I throw on my LUT, it doesn't quite work as well. It pushes the brightness all the way up to the full. There's something in how Adobe is interpreting that Log 3G10 and doing that movement that we don't actually need the LUT with the RAWs, which is nice, but it also doesn't color match with the proxy initially. Now, that said, both of these are really great starting points for grading. And so if you're consistent with how you're grading in your timeline, working with the ProRes is a really great starting place. In either case, I can sit there and we're going to turn off this LUT. I can adjust my exposure, I can adjust my contrast, and dial in the image that I want. Let's boost the saturation and really make those reds pop. When I do just a couple of adjustments, it starts looking really, really nice. So I hope you found this quick tutorial on the quirks of working in HDR in Adobe Premiere and doing color management and color grading in HDR in Adobe Premiere useful. You can pick up the LUTs that I've built at bilodoservices.com/LUTs. Go ahead and download those. You can download them for free. Use them to handle the color management for your AVC and ProRes content, your camera logs, to get a good starting point for your HDR grades. If you found this video useful, go ahead and subscribe to this channel. I'll periodically be posting tips and tricks for working in different HDR programs, reviews of some HDR technology, and other things that I found useful for working in HDR over the years. I'm Sam with Bilodo Services, and I'll see you next time.